the thrill of victory.
The youngest champion.
And the agony of defeat.
Look at him go!
Oh, baby.
No, no.
This is ABC's Wide World of Sports. Coming up next on Deep Weather College Basketball, number 3 North Carolina versus number 1 Duke, the rematch. At 4:30, the WBC Lightweight Championship, Steve Johnston versus George Scott. Today on ABC's Wide World of Sports.
Walking off the court against UNC the first time, I felt embarrassed.
I let down everyone who ever put on a Duke uniform.
You know, it's a feeling that, you know, I don't ever want to have again.
But we didn't come to play, and UNC did.
A rivalry brings about the best and worst in the human spirit, transcending sport, mutating into an art form. A rivalry is often born of jealousy, coveting thy neighbor's success. Confrontations filled with physical aggression, emotional angst, acrimony passed along as if it were a family crest. Why do I hold you in low esteem? Because my predecessors did. Voices from distant places, awakened by the call. Sleep, dream, is it real? Rise again, Blue Devils, rise, exorcise those demons. Come play in the hollows where past demons lay. When you face your rival, 110% is not only cliche, it's underachieving. Newspapers spewing headlines, bragging rights in bold letters. When rivals meet, middle-aged alumni struggle to close vintage Letterman jackets. Mistakes are magnified, victory much sweeter. So stare down your rival, for the misguided notion we'll get them next time is this time.
And on top of everything else, it's senior day. Steve Wojciechowski, one of the all-time favorites at Cameron Indoor Stadium, being introduced prior to his final game in Durham. It's round 2, North Carolina and Duke. We're only minutes away.
Vein Weber College Basketball on ABC and Raycom Sports. Brought to you by Payne Weber. When you invest with Payne Weber, you invest with more intelligence. Toyota, every day belongs to you. Make it count, Toyota, every day. MCI 5 Cent Sundays, pay the least on the day you call the most. And State Farm Insurance, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. World of Sports Studio in New York, here's John Saunders.
And welcome to a very big weekend of sports here on ABC. Auto racing tomorrow, boxing later today, but we begin with college basketball. The Field of 64 is starting to take shape. Princeton already win. They got their third consecutive Ivy League title, and today the TAC championship also being decided, just ended moments ago. Jermell President scores on the layup. He had 15 points. Shane McCravey had 17, second straight TAC championship for the College of Charleston. Now, Arizona can also go in, looking to become the seventh school to win back-to-back championships. And since 10-team conference, no one has gone undefeated in the Pac-10. Arizona will get a bid if they win. Don't forget, at 4:30 Eastern and Pacific, the WBC Lightweight Championship. Steve Johnston defends his title and puts his perfect record on the line against George Scott in Atlantic City. Next on ABC Sports, that's the lightweights. Up next, it's the heavyweights. Duke against North Carolina. We'll see you at halftime.
Presents the very best in college basketball, Duke and North Carolina. North Carolina and Duke. For 58 years, all kinds of magic has unfolded in Cameron Indoor Stadium. Duke has won almost 600 games in this building, but none bigger than today. Good afternoon. Welcome, everybody, along with Dick Vitale. I'm Brent Musburger. 8 miles apart, the toughest 8 miles in college basketball, Durham and Chapel Hill, North Carolina to Duke. At stake today, the regular season title in the ACC and a possible number one seeding in the NCAA's East Region. Then on top of it all, Mike Krzyzewski is shooting for his 500th career victory. It just doesn't get any better than Duke in North Carolina. And I'll tell you, Dick, there's a very special feeling for everybody in this building, but your heart goes out to the players here.
I'll tell you one thing, Brent. Players and coaches dream of moments like this. This is what you go to a school like Duke in North Carolina for. Think back. It was only 23 days ago and about 16 hours when Duke was in their locker room and they were flat out humiliated and embarrassed. They were beaten by 24 points. Antoine Jameson was sensational. He had 35 points and dominated in the lane. In fact, they shot 21 for 36 in the first half and they had 16 layups. It was blowout city. But the bottom line is they are at home today, Duke, with the friendly confines of Cameron Indoor Stadium. And they have the presence inside now of Elton Brand to give them another physical player. But the bottom line is they still have to find an answer for Antoine Jameson and Vince Carter. No doubt we have two of the great programs in America. Players graduate. They do things the right way. They win basketball games. And when you talk about superstar talent, we have them here today. Hoda versus Wojciechowski. Watch that matchup.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's meet this afternoon's starting lineups. First for the Tar Heels of the University of North Carolina, a 6'7 junior from a 6'9 junior from Berlin, Germany, number 13, Adamola Okalaja. Standing 6'7 and a junior from Daytona Beach, Florida, number 15, Vince Carter. At 6'9 and a junior from Charlotte, North Carolina, number 33, Antoine Jameson. Standing 6'3 and a senior from Greenville, South Carolina, number 3, Shaman Williams. And a 6'1 sophomore from Brooklyn, New York, number 5, Ed Cota. Your head coach, Mr. Bill Guthridge. And now for your Blue Devils. At 6'8 and a senior from Jersey City, New Jersey, number 4, Roshan McLeod. A senior from Carson, California, number 3, Ricky Price. At 6'8 and a freshman from Birmingham, Michigan, number 31, Shane Battier. Standing 6'3 and a junior from Anchorage, Alaska, number 21, Trajan Langdon. And at 5'11 and a senior from Severna Park, Maryland, number 12, Steve Wojciechowski. Your head coach, Mr. Mike Krzyzewski.
Dr. Art Chandler introducing our starting lineups here for this showdown today. Carolina's record 27-2. They're 13-2 in the ACC. Duke 26-2, but 14-1 in the conference. Now we can take a look at our Toyota starting lineups for today's showdown in Cameron. North Carolina on the left, Duke on the right. Price to be honored because he's a senior, and that's why he's starting in this game here today, Dick.
Yeah, there's no question Ricky Price has not had a super senior year, Brent. He's being rewarded with the opportunity because it's senior day, but the bottom line is he didn't gain his eligibility until the latter part of December, and he has not been the player that he was last year as a premier sixth man and also the year before when he made third team all ACC. I'll tell you, Brent, I think there's another factor involved in this game. You and I talked about it. You're perspiring, I'm perspiring. I think heat and fatigue could play a major role in this game, especially when North Carolina utilizes only six players.
I would certainly agree with that, Dick. The other thing to watch early, last week against UCLA, Duke climbed all over them in the early minutes. North Carolina needs to relax, hold off that early surge, and then settle down. We are set to go. Tap is controlled by the Heels. Bellagio will drop it in. Jamison, there he goes again. His first field goal. He hit him for 35 in game one.
I'll tell you, so easy how he got the ball inside. In his two previous games here, Brent, he's only averaging 10.5 a game, 31 in the three games at the arena down at Chapel Hill.
Over Price and on the turnover. Punched hard by Williams on the right side. Carolina would love a positive start.
They got Battier playing right now. The freshman trying to handle Jamison inside. There's a matchup that I think is big. Wojciechowski and Kota.
Here comes Carter on the turnaround. 4-0. And Carolina opens with their first two field goals successfully.
Well, that's the way you want to start here, to quiet this crowd. You want to be able to get them out of the game early.
Langdon. Fadeaway. Yes.
I'll tell you, he's been sensational. You and I had the game against UCLA. 34 big ones.
Wojciechowski using the baseline as an extra defender, keeping Kota on that side. Now Carter looks in, drops low. Foul, and Jamison to the free throw line. Dick, you told me yesterday after attending practice that they were going to front Jamison, and that time they prevented him from getting that pass down low, but they still fouled him.
Well, they're trying to front him down here to rotate people over. See Battier getting up in front, but he holds position so well at 6'8", and he's so quick. His catch and release is the quickest in the game, Brent. He's my choice as National Player of the Year. He's been superb all year long.
3 points for him already in the early going. Will Guthridge, 31 years an assistant, first year as a head coach, and a lot of folks say he's the National Coach of the Year for taking over the Dean Smith program and accomplishing what he did. Jamison comes back, and now he's hit both his free throws, 4 points.
I'll tell you, Antoine Jamison's the kind of player that rises for moments like this. That's what PT peers do. They really love the special stage.
Lojo drops it into Battier, and they double down, force the turnover on that double team low. Carter now with the pass. Kota across the timeline. Kota looking to penetrate. Great pass. And a block by Battier, but back to Carolina. Williams has it taken away. Here comes Price. Remember, he's only starting because he's a senior. Gives it up to Wojo. Tried to get it in low, and Kota fouled McLeod.
Let us not forget that North Carolina has dominated this series in the last 10 games. They have won 9 out of 10. We're going to watch penetration here. Ed Kota with a little bounce pass. He's one of the great passers in basketball. And there's Battier, who leads them in block shots and in total rebounds. Great Viper Dander.
Wojciechowski gives up his dribble. Back to Langdon. 6-2, Dick. Carolina with an early lead.
They got to play Langdon really tough. You can't give him good looks like UCLA did. It was embarrassing as UCLA was pummeled by giving him open shots.
Now Battier into the paint for the jump shot. Missing. One and out. Here comes Kota again. He was the spark plug down the stretch after Duke pulled it within four. It was Kota penetrating that sealed Duke's fate in game one. And Antoine Jamison just continues to stroke away perfect.
Hey, partner, they're not making any doubt whatsoever. They're going to their superstar early. They say, find a remedy to stop him because no one has been able to stop him yet.
We will see Elton Brand before long in this game. Cloud on a pull-up, and again, it is one and out. Carolina doing a beautiful job on the defensive glass. 8-2, the kind of start you need in Cameron. Keeps the crazies out of it.
See, Battier can't handle him one-on-one inside, Brand. He can't handle him. He's going to have to get help. He's trying to deny him the basketball.
Williams short on the pull-up. But it is Antoine has it taken away, and Wojo left side. But there's no manpower advantage. Carolina, an outstanding defensive team, was able to drop back. That's the underrated part of Carolina's game. Langdon's three. No.
That's
and
great.
Again, one and out, Dick.
Great point you just made about their defense being underrated. They lead the ACC in field goal percentage defensively, 38%. A lot of people aren't aware of that. I think the best pressure defense certainly belongs to Duke.
Stepping out is Carter, and here comes Jamison. He'll fire the three up on the top and goes back to Duke on his first miss.
He's worked on his range as a shooter. Here comes Elton Brand to give a little physical presence at 14 points in 16 minutes against UCLA. As you look here, what the records were prior to his injury and after his injury, 2-0. You know, sluggish right now, but just the fact that he's on the floor, to me, is a great psychological lift for the Duke kids.
Williams fires the three from the corner, and it was good. Shamon Williams hits his first three.
Hey, Brent, he's a big game performer. MVP last year, the ACC tournament, the MVP of the regionals. He loves the big moment as well, and he can flat out shoot the three.
Chris Carwell has checked in for Price. Langdon penetrates, pull up jump shot, and he puts two on the board, and now he has four.
Great jump stop out there. You young kids should work on that. The Alaskan Assassin. Hoda against Woja. Look at that matchup.
Hoda got inside and threw him, and the foul is going to be called. You wonder, Dick, about Wojo's speed in this matchup against Kota.
Also, size is a factor here. As we take a look at Trajan Langdon, see the jump stop? Look at that little jump stop. He's got a little extra setup. Great jump shot right there. Now we look at Eddie Kota. He's flash. He can handle the rock. Great vision. Great change of direction to beat Kota and force the foul.
Kota hit that free throw line. Great on the road, hit those free throws. You know the importance of that.
Great story. Mom and dad are here. We're in a serious crash several years ago. His stepdad is paralyzed now, and he's here at the game with Rock Eisenberg, the fine high school coach who coached him at Tilden High School in Brooklyn.
Well, they certainly enjoyed watching his son make those two free throws. North Carolina builds an early lead. Remember, this is what they did in round one in Chapel Hill. We'll continue. North Carolina builds an early lead, and back in game one, Jamison exploded in the first half for 23 points, was 9 of 11. He's off big here again, 13-4 the lead, Duke basketball.
Now to come out in the zone right now, North Carolina, multiple defenses.
Knocked away from the freshman. Carwell has it stripped, and Jai dribbles over to the corner.
Jai really played well in their last game. They were down 14 against Wake Forest. As we look at a rebound total, 6-1. He had 16, his career high. Been a solid player from all year, Jai.
And William now 2 for 2 from trifecta land. Shaman with 6 quick points. 16-4, early Tar Heel blowout.
He walked right there, walking violation. They got a really find himself right now. Shaman Williams wide open. You can't allow him to get open. The kid's a flat-out tremendous shooter. He'll knock that trifecta down all day, Brent, if he gets it. Look good. Look at the goal.
The one risk that Duke faced here today, and it was a big one, was being too emotional about this rematch in front of this student body. Putting out too much effort in the early going. Carolina obviously poised. Carter on a turnaround. They look magnificent in the early going.
I'll tell you, they're magnificent. You got that right. They're super scintillating, sensational. What great execution. Now they're zoning. Tough to zone this club, though, basically, because they shoot so well, Duke.
McLeod's three.
That's what I mean, Brent. It's tough to zone them because they step in gaps so well, and they're so lethal from the trifecta with guys like McLeod, Wojciechowski, and Langdon, and Chappelle, and Avery.
Okalaja. They play catch outside the perimeter, and Carter gives it up now to Kota. Kota looking to penetrate. Got a screen. Offensive foul is going to be called.
Shaman Williams does such a great job in their offense, their execution. That's why they lead the nation in field goal percentage. They do such a beautiful job getting people free for shots. When you talk about North Carolina, as you look at Williams.
We've got a fresh face. Freshman Chris Burgess, 6'10", checks in, and McLeod sits down. Jamison steps out with Burgess right now, and Wojo comes around the way.
Burgess's entire family's here. Dad, mom, brothers from out of California. Went west.
Langdon pull up three. Off iron and offensive rebound by Brandt. Fade away short. Rebound by Jamison.
See, Brandt's timing rhythm isn't what it was earlier when he was leading the club and rebounding the score prior to that injury.
Kota on the drive, draws the foul.
See, right now, the aggressor is certainly North Carolina. Duke right now is playing on its heels as we watch Shaman Williams right now getting free. See, right here, we're going to watch him. Just keep an eye on Shaman. Now we're going to watch him right now drift. He floats to the corner. No one comes out of place. Right there. Freeze it. Right there. See, wide open. You can't leave him open, Brent. That's right in the goal, baby. That's down. Nothing but net. He can shoot that trifecta.
Four team fouls in the early going on Duke. Kota makes him pay again. He's 100% at the free throw. throw line, and they'll try a different point guard. They'll see if they get some more speed on Cota. William Avery, a 6'2 freshman. Avery did not have the kind of game he'd like to remember in Chapel Hill. In fact, it was a nightmare as Cota puts two on, total of four, and it's 20-7. North Carolina over Duke.
Well, Avery would like to have a game like he had against Arizona when he had 21 and knocked out four threes.
He did penetrate that time and draw the foul.
He's
so there was nothing bashful about the young man as he came right down the paint with his first possession.
He's not afraid to shoot the rock. I tell you, it's real silent here. It was like explosive before the game. Nothing like an early lead by the visiting team to quiet the crowd.
I'll bet my Tar Heel fans are not quiet. Hope's nearby over there in Chapel Hill are alive with the sound of success. Avery now with a free throw.
I like Bill Guthridge's line before the game to you and I. Said to him, hey, Bill, you've had a great year your first year. He says, wait a minute now. I hope we haven't had the highlight yet.
You know, that calm that he exudes, I think, works on this basketball team.
Oh,
they are very calm here today.
And don't forget, he learned from the best. I mean, the Hall of Famer, the legend, Dean Smith. They're playing the same offensive system, same defensive system, and they returned six of their top seven players from last year's outstanding team.
It's going to be a foul on Brandy. Hook Antoine Jameson as he started by. But remember a point that Dick made early. And I'm going to repeat it. It's a long, hot day in Cameron. Duke, a much deeper basketball team. Yes, right now it's all North Carolina, but we'll see if they can hold up.
Well, they were shocked when they were down 50-34 in the first game. I believe Duke was absolutely stunned and did not know how to react in terms of coming back.
Jameson spots up. Yes, and that's the one thing that a lot of Bro Scouts want to see about him. That's 8 points, and North Carolina 7 of 10 as they blaze away against this Duke team.
Well, they're carving in the park, getting good shots, good ball movement and player movement will create opportunities. See, I think the system right now, the Duke's pressure defense plays into the hands of North Carolina. They love pressure defense.
And there's another turnover. That is 5 turnovers by Krzyzewski's team in the early going.
Look at Jameson right now. See, I don't think Grant's quick enough right now to check him. And there's a little screen. He's going to take him away from the goal, utilize his quickness, and he's improved his range, as you just said, Brent. He's improved his range as a shooter.
Brendan Haywood checks in at the pivot for Carolina, the 7-foot youngster.
There he is.
There he is underneath and slammed it down and fouled. And what an impact he made.
And then what a little dance. He had one of his greatest moments in that first matchup when they made the run, Duke, and cut it to four. He played big. Nice dish inside him. He's like the 3D man, Shimon. Drive, draw, and dish the rock right open for the jam.
Krzyzewski unhappy with the officiating, but for the most part, his team is simply not playing as well as Carolina. We got a timeout, 24-9, Heels. Seasons, the Tar Heels have been this man's nemesis. And just a short time ago, he was certainly not happy with the performance of his team. The free throw made, the three-point play the old-fashioned way by Haywood.
I'll tell you one thing, they got to learn how to react from coming from behind. They've had so many big leads. They blew out Maryland by 32, Wake by 36. They beat Maryland again by 27, UCLA by 36. And I'm telling you, they have to learn how to come from behind.
Avery misses the three, tap, scramble for the loose ball underneath, and it's going to be the possession arrow. Now, I want to go back to moments ago. We told you he was angry. Folks, during that timeout, it was the most animated that I have seen Krzyzewski this early in one of these showdowns. He is clearly displeased with the performance of his team.
Well, he wanted them to compete. He felt they did not compete in a first matchup. He said that was not Duke basketball, where you play with your heart, your guts, and your courage. The bottom line is also on the other side, Carolina, Brent, they've been able to come back this year. They were down 17. You and I did the game against Wake Forest. They were down 14 to Wake in the last matchup. They were down 12 with Purdue, 7 with 2 minutes to go against Georgia. So they've been able to react in adversity. Look at those numbers. Wow.
Every turnover has been converted to a basket by the Tar Heels. They have been opportunistic. Wojo penetrates, slashes back for the three on the inside-outside move, and there's Trajan Langdon. 7 now for the first half, and Duke exerting some full-court pressure. They're going to pick up Williams. They take the ball. They don't want it in Double O's hands, and here comes Carter.
Hey, Brent,
he's at Dandy.
You can't zone this club. They tried zoning Wojciechowski, got in the gap, and got it to Langdon, who's a great shooter. Got to play man-to-man.
12-minute mark, first half. Carter, pull-up three. In and out. Buck Williams with the rebound. Good. 8 points.
He's automatic. I tell you, you can't give them the second opportunity. They rotate out of the zone, and they come to man-to-man. Good decision by Bill Guthridge. They'll carve that zone apart.
What a great start by North Carolina.
Exactly what they prescribed. I tell you, they couldn't plan it any better.
Wojo plays two-man basketball with Cloud with a miss, and Jamison out.
Getting one shot, not getting second or third opportunity.
Here comes Shamond again, in and out this time. But Haywood runs down the rebound, but there's going to be a foul called against the Tar Heels.
Yeah, good call right there. No question about it. We got some good officials on this game here today. A good team as you watch Shamond Williams. Second opportunity, just count it, take it out of the net, baby.
Rick Hartzell, Steve Gordon, Frank Scagliata, a team that works very well together, and it has been very cleanly officiated here in the early going. 27-12, Tar Heels 11-15 left first half. Langdon coming up firing with a three.
Can't let him shoot the rock if he squares his body, but he needs some help. You know what's missing today from Duke Grant is their defensive pressure. They're not forcing turnovers, creating any opportunities, and they usually live off their defense.
Well, Guthridge has put the ball a lot in Williams' hands, bringing it up and letting Cota run free, which is a bit of a surprise. They use that against some teams as a changeup. Cota now will bring it back and set the offense.
Well, what they tried to do is take the ball away from Wojciechowski. Now they got Wojo switching out, playing Shamond Williams.
Bad pass, turn it over, Duke ball.
See, that's what they utilize really well. When they get their team defenses going and force the turnovers, it usually creates havoc. And that's what it's been all year for the opposition.
Wojo on the dribble.
Man-to-man defense, getting out of the zone. Wojo now with Williams. Cota checking him.
Knocked away from Avery. Mikolajic jumping out to knock the ball out of bounds. And a reminder coming up next, the WBC Lightweight Championship. Steve Johnston undefeated. You may want to watch him against George Scott next right here on ABC Sports after these two college basketball heavyweights finish their tussle. And Cameron Hunter, no. And it's out on that shot. He was expecting a lot more defensive pressure than he received as he came down the line. I think Wojo was surprised, and Cota quickly comes to the attack.
They're playing Jai together right now with Haywood. Haywood also was big in their game.
Stepped out of bounds. That's Duke ball.
Also made some big plays against Clemson.
Now that is five Tar Heel turnovers in this game. So the worm's starting to turn just a bit in that category.
See, now look at Haywood right now. Look at the help coming rotated over.
27-15. Heels lead it. We're at the 10-minute mark.
I tell you, Duke leads the nation in margin of scoring up 25 points a game. They've been blowing people, averaging 25 plus. That's amazing.
That foul is on Williams.
They haven't been able to put that big momentum, that little run, to really get this crowd to really rise. Bill Guthridge's club has really stymied the crowd with their great early performance.
Here's McLeod to two. Wouldn't stay down. Outlet pass. They put it into Cota's hands. Could make all ACC. A lot of individual honors at stake here today. Forced to his knees and keeps on dribbling. That's why he's such an outstanding man to have on the basketball. Look at this change. In the lane, he flashes. Knocked back, though. There's contact underneath going against Carolina.
I'll tell you, McLeod's going to have to step it up offensively and give him some productivity, something he's been doing really great in the ACC. In fact, he's their leading scorer in ACC action. A little shake and bake right here. New York City, ball handling. Look at him handling a rock. I mean, he can flat out handle the rocks. Got great vision. See, you young kids, keep the head up all the time so you have vision of open people.
Now we're inside of 9.5 minutes, and it's 27-15. Duke looking for a spurt right now. They also struggled offensively on the interior in game one, as they're doing here, and McLeod is faking the lane.
Nice. Good
for him now, and that gives him 5 for the game.
That's the kid I just told you, Brent's got to step it up, and he got there with Jamison Gordon to make Jamison play some defense. Now here come the Dukies. The crowd is in it.
And Carter will be shooting free throws. There's no better team at working the alley-oop pass than bringing Pota down and have him lob it in. Here is McLeod's field goal just a second ago at the other end. As now Vince Carter steps up to the free throw line, I want to tell you, no one, but no one in college basketball throws the lob pass any better than Carolina. It is amazing to watch. And you've got athletes like Carter and Jamison Lowe. Look out below.
I'll tell you one thing. Eddie Cota throws it well. The best I ever saw in college was Sherman Douglas when he used to hook up at Syracuse. And let me tell you this, as Carter's on the line, let me give you a little scoop. All the NBA scouts who are here say the Super Six right now in the college game, separate from everyone else, Carter, Jamison, Pierce, LaFrance, Bibby, and a young man, remember this name, Michael Olowokandi, a seven-footer from out of Pacific.
Off the iron, rebound by the Tar Heels. We'll get to the draft after this game. Passes in low, and Jamison traveled on the reception underneath. At the line right now, North Carolina perfect for Guthridge. They're 8 of 8.
Well, they were 12 for 12 in their last game on a free throw line, so they're really hot right now, Brent. Great job defensively, though, in transition by Duke getting that. Got to get some dribble penetration out of Wojciechowski to create opportunities. He's got to try to get in the gap. Ah, picked up his dribble. That's a no-no.
Roll down the baseline. He's sealed up. Tried to get it deep. Burgess runs it down and taps it to Wojo. Plenty of time in the college game. Still 15 on that shot clock. A lot of these fellows find it a lot different when you start playing with a 24-second shot clock. That's an entirely different kind of basketball game. Wojciechowski now comes out over five. Here is Lane. He's got to go. There's three, two. Penetrates. Got to pull it up and release. Short on the shot, but hit the iron. Fresh 25, or I should say, fresh 35. Here's Langdon, and he's fouled by Jamison, no question about it.
And you don't want to put him on the line. He's automatic. He's the premier free throw shooter in the conference. Better than 90%, the Alaskan assassin, Trajan Langdon. What an amazing year Duke has had, though. In fact, both these clubs, when you think about it, I mean, it's just amazing. Only four losses all year. They've been beating up all the clubs in the conference, and that's why the conference right now is really in trouble about NCAA berths. I still think they're going to get five. We got a big game tomorrow with Georgia Tech and Clemson.
Winner could get in. Loser may be out. That's really right. Better than that as Langdon now, Dick, with 11 points as he steps back to the free throw line for his second attempt here. And Duke slowly whittling away. Missed it.
Wow, wow. That's a scoop right there, baby. I mean, are you kidding me? He looked like Brett Musburger shooting that free throw. Come on, big fella.
Now Cota over to the left-hand side. Here's Jai, who's back in the game. Wanted a low tap out of bounds by Carwell. Carolina ball.
Not a good look right there. They telegraphed that one, trying to drive the pass in for the dunk.
Let's take a timeout. North Carolina leads Duke 29-18 in round two.
Shoot the three. We're going to watch right now against the zone defense of North Carolina why they can't zone. We'll watch the opportunity. Freeze it right here. He's going to kick it out right here, square his body, and that baby's going right down, right in the gap. He gets right in the seam, squares his body. They've made 219 threes coming into this game. Last year, they broke a school record with 279.
Dick Duke desperately needs some balance. Langdon with 11 of their 18 points right now. For Carolina, Okalaja, the only starter who has not scored in this game. Duke struggling to find someone to help Trajan.
They're not getting anything inside. They're not getting any presence in the post. And that was the same story in game one. Carolina just dominated the lane inside. 21 for 36 they shot in the first half for 68%. Duke shoots 50% as a team. They shot 33% in game one against North Carolina. Humiliated.
And Duke hitting only 35% here. Elijah still cold, missing, and Langdon with the rebound. Duke is 6 of 17. That's all so far here in the first half. Avery looking to penetrate, kick it on back to Langdon. Inside-outside game. And now, coming off a weave, Carwell drives, misses. Antoine has it knocked away. Tracked down, though, by Carolina. And here comes Williams. They got a 5-on-4. Burgess went to the floor. They got a manpower advantage. Here's Okalaja pass into the middle now. And Giles take the jump shot. Rattles out. Now Avery will try to pressure the floor. Avery coming to glass. Avery misses. And it's by Burgess.
Oh, this
is the biggest field goal of the half, in my opinion, for Duke. It made it 29-20. It got the crazies alive. They were sitting on their hands until Jam City occurred here. And now let's see what the Heels come back with. Williams going to penetrate. Williams going to pass, a little too tricky. And there's going to be a call against. Foul is going to be called down on the inside.
Lewis Krzyzewski now talking to the ref. He said, yeah, you want to go to dinner today? I'll take you to dinner. I got a lot of guests here today. There's Avery taking the ball, the combination guard strong. And here is Mr. Burgess with the trail. I keep waiting for him to break out. You and I talked about it with each other, watching him warm up, how impressed we were with Mr. Burgess.
Well, he showed us something right there, Dick. And incidentally, that is the second foul on Brand right now. When you look at the foul situation for Duke, McLeod playing with two, Wojo with two, now Brand with two. No wonder Mike wants to go to work on the officials. It's Antoine Jamison with 9 points here in the first half, and Chappelle, Mike Chappelle, the 6'8 sophomore, checks in. Langdon will sit down.
You just saw the last Tar Heel to lead the conference in scoring since a guy by the name of Michael the Magnificent, Mr. Jordan, the greatest ever to lace them up. Not even close anymore in terms of Jordan versus the rest of the NBA players of all time.
So there's a reminder, Dick has already mentioned it, Georgia Tech Clemson here in ACC land. Kansas, how far can they go? Would be nice if Roy Williams could win a championship. And UMass at Temple in the Atlantic 10. We've got a good lineup for you tomorrow. It is early. We're going to go out to Las Vegas for that debut of that NASCAR race. What a crowd they'll have there. Burgess gets inside, misses on the shot, and Antoine Jamison, a great rebounder, but a bad pass to Carter over his head.
Burgess hesitated right there rather than just take it up and go strong. You mentioned Roy Williams, who sat on that staff as an assistant, averaging 27 W's over the last 10 years. His son is on the sideline. He sits on a bench for North Carolina. He scored 3 points this year. That's more than Roy ever scored in his career. And Roy was so proud of his son in that performance.
It's an 11-point advantage for the Tar Heels.
There's the zone right now. See, I think that plays into the hands of Duke. I think the zone is something that they would like to see.
It forces Chappelle back outside the arc.
Got to go inside, get some touches inside, and then bring it to the perimeter.
You know, I think Vince Carter's about as good a defensive player as I watch in college basketball this year. He's outstanding. Here comes Brand. Brand to the glass, and he drew the foul. He will be shooting a couple of free throws now. That's the kind of muscle they could use if Brand can deliver it.
His timing certainly not what it was prior to the injury. As he's inside, he said, give me the rock. Come on, give me the rock inside. He said, please give it to me. Come on, give it to me. I'm a big guy. I'm physical. He can't handle me. He said, get Mr. Jamison away from me. Just bring me the ball.
I think I was watching a tape of your game one. You did it with Mike Patrick. And I remember at halftime, you showed Brand in civilian clothes, and I will not forget the graphic because it said out for season with broken foot. What an unbelievable job the medical staff has done here at Duke, and the young man himself. They operated right away. They inserted the screw that helped healing. Then they used a harness to keep him above a treadmill so the weight would be off it. He kept his weight down. In fact, he lost 2 pounds during rehab. He's a young man named Desire, and it is great to see him back. And I got to tell you something. If I was running a professional sports team and I had a knee or an ankle or something, and you wondered whether or not to have surgery, I'd call the Duke medical staff. This is flat out as good a medical staff as exists in the world.
Well, that's why it's a great advantage going here. It's another asset they provide with that Duke hospital. They do a phenomenal job. Now here comes full court pressure, and they got it to single digits.
Up front now to Williams.
Got to contain Williams. Can't give him good looks. They got Chappelle playing Williams right now to get the matchup. Wojo and Cota's been basically equal right now. No one's really dominating that spot.
Williams. Not quite the daylight he wanted. He got it to Okalaja out of bounds. Okalaja took a bump and went out of bounds. And they've turned it over 8 times. And Guthrie said, wasn't he bumped out? Don't we get a whistle on that play down there? You got to blow the whistle on that. Come on. But, you know, look at Guthrie. He's a gentleman. Now, Vitale will be all over that official.
I've been all over. Guthrie.
Oh, okay.
I've been using my Thank choice you, Italian. I'll tell you, on Scagliata. The last 5:20, North Carolina, 0. I see a little momentum swinging a little bit to the Dukie side. If they can make a little run here, Uncle Mo would be a big lift for them coming out after the half.
Well, let's see. No. Offensive foul. They waste an opportunity as Chappelle commits the personal and turns it over. 31-22, 4:59. They have steadied themselves, Dick. They were horrendous shooting in the first few minutes of the game. And Jamison and company Just hit everything in sight, and that was the difference.
There's the Duke bench. Got to be a concerned look on their faces because all year long they've been blowing people out at halftime. Remember, again, what's at stake. Number one seed in the East, which means Greensboro, and that's a big, big plus. Even Mike Krzyzewski told me that yesterday. He says, no bones about it. That's a great advantage. You don't have to get in a plane. You play in front of your fans down in Greensboro, and they want that battle.
Bouncing low now, Jamison jump hook in the paint, and Antoine Jamison with a dozen here.
And he simply says, they may want it, but they got to find a way to stop me because it's been an M&M-er on the inside, a mismatch. No one can handle Jamison.
Wojo being defended by Williams, and he hits Carwell to give it back to Wojo. Try a deep three, in and out, and Jamison another rebound.
Well, these 4 minutes big right now. North Carolina gets a run here. They can put Duke in a big hole.
Thought about the three, got it inside Antoine Jamison, the open man. You cannot give him a layup. That's 14 points.
He's so quick the way he catches the ball and scores. In our game, the first matchup, our people at ESPN charted 53 seconds he touched the ball in the course of the game and scored and produced 35 points. That's an amazing stat.
Down low to Bland in the paint, comes up firing, drew the foul.
It's been a steady uphill battle for Duke in their matchups here. See right now, look at Jamison, how active he is. And he posts so well. There's that little spin and jump hook where he seals the defensive player off. Now look at him run the court. Look at him run the court. He said to me before the game, he said, you know, I'm not worried about it. They say this crowd's intimidating. They scream. As long as they stay in the stands, he said, the baskets are still 10 foot high, and they got to put somebody to check me. How's that for confidence?
Here's Elton Brand missing that free throw. He made two previously. Langdon returns for Krzyzewski. Duke trailing. They've trailed all the way. It's 35-22. They've got just inside of 4 minutes to go.
This is a character checkup right now for the Duke kids. They're behind again. They're at home. They're in the friendly confines of Cameron. They got to battle back somehow.
Well, here's Maktar Jai saying, yes, baby, all Tar Heels, but a long way to go. Timeout.
Payne Weber College Basketball on ABC Sports. Brought to you by Toyota Trucks. Tough, durable, every day. The United States Army Reserve. Be all you can be. State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And Wendy's Big Bacon Classic. You can taste the difference fresh makes.
There are all kinds of celebrities enjoying Antoine Jamison's performance here, Dick.
That was Urkel. There's Charles Rose. I know. We talked to him before the game. And there's Steve Wynn of the Mirage. That's right. Mirage Faith, the owner of the 76ers. Should be a manager, a trainer. The guy was a trainer, now Pet Mr. Proshi, a big owner. Unbelievable. And there's the star of stars here right now, Mr. Jamison, 14-7.
35-23, the Tar Heels with 3:44 to go. They have dominated the action here early.
Changed defense for the first time. He's going to a zone. Duke has come out in a man-to-man, going to a zone. It's like a 1-3-1. Changes with the alignment of the basketball.
Pull up three from Shamond, and he's feeling it today. Remember, Shamond Williams with 11. You know what he did this week? A surprise visit to Tent City. Came over to Krzyzewskiville, dropped in a tent, had a nice discussion with some Duke students, said it was very friendly. And I think as a result, they're not picking on him as much as they might. And hold on, no shot here as a pushing foul is going to be called before the shot. And a reminder of what we've got tonight. Here's your primetime lineup on ABC. Casper, and then we'll have an ABC News Saturday night special. We'll start at 8 Eastern on ABC.
Mr. McLeod going to that free throw line. Hey, Shimon's eyes, they got like a half dollar when he saw that zone defense. I mean, he just got big. I tell you, I can't believe how stunned and how shocked this crowd is.
As quiet as you're going to Didn't help McLeod either. He did a little noise back there. He said, where's everybody gone? They go home? Go to the library?
Got to study.
Don't get on us now.
You know, 1,400 SATs, you got to do a little study in here. Between you and me, we took it three times. We totaled 1,400. They were live before the game. This place was electricity.
Well, they've been outside camp for 2 months. Maybe they lost a little energy out there. As McLeod adds the free throw, he has scored 6 points for Duke here in the first half. 38 24. We've got 3 minutes to go, and Duke in need of a little spurt. They'd love to get this down to 10 by the intermission, just inside of that magic figure. You know how coaches like to play the game that way when you're trailing big time. And Okalaja, who's not had his shot, gives it up.
What great poise by this North Carolina team. A tribute to Bill Guthridge and his staff. They really come in here with a lot of patience, making the extra pass, hitting the wide open shot. Great shot selection.
Fake Okalaja drives to the paint and comes up with a muscle. Did not get the bounce, but the big seven-footer, Brendan Haywood, with 5 points. There was no answer underneath.
I'll tell you, Haywood factor becoming big at 7 feet. You can't teach that.
McLeod's three. Good. Rashawn, nine for the first half.
Did they ever need that big trifecta? What about Stanford getting blitzed by better than like 40 by Arizona? Unbelievable. They need to stop right now, Brandon. A conversion on the other end of the floor.
Carter steps out.
Great spacing. 15, 17 feet apart. Makes it very difficult to give help defensively.
Now it's Williams. They bring the shot clock inside of 10. Haywood, and he traveled. Took that extra step before he put it down. And on the turnover, Duke's basketball.
They got some positive minutes out of Mr. Haywood. See, take a look right here. Freeze it right here. Freeze it. See this spacing? 15 feet apart. That means that you got great, great spacing right here. See, here it is. Look at the spacing. Can't give help. They got great spacing between one another. You'd like to be 15 to 17 feet apart. It's a trademark of their great motion game. That's why they lead the nation, Grant. Shooting better than 50%. Almost every year, they're right up on top.
McLeod coming again. In and out, tap back up. No by Battier. Williams goes to the corner. Duke ball.
I'll tell you, McLeod and Battier have not been major factors here today. And when you think about McLeod, he's had 27, 25, and 23-point explosions recently. You said it earlier. You said it so well. How calm and cool North Carolina is and how they're not intimidated at all coming into this building. Winning 9 of their last 10 meetings against that Blue Devil uniform.
Well, I think North Carolina State gave him the wake-up call with that enormous upset in Chapel Hill. Avery, no. And Carter, what a strong rebound as he reached back.
And in that game, they did everything perfect. They had the perfect formula, Herb send explode. Made all the threes early.
Turn it over. Here they come. Dick on a manpower.
Give it to McLeod. Give Avery. It to McLeod.
Fake McLeod. He traveled. He should have gone right to the glass on the pass.
2-on-1, usually that's an automatic in a Duke system. Stay a little wider than the foul line. But, you know, getting back to an NC State game, C.C. Harrison, as you look at Krzyzewski on the sideline, you're going to see the reaction, frustration. He made 7 threes in the first half and then went 25 for 25 at one time in the second half on a free throw line.
If nothing else, the Blue Devils need to relax in this game. They have played tense, and that's no way to play this Tar Heel team. Loose ball's going Carolina's way. Three misses that time, but Battier seals off the man. It comes down with a defensive rebound and then draws the foul from Haywood.
Not a good foul right there, Brent. That's a mistake in that situation.
Well, we've got the MCI halftime report. Our friend John Saunders, that'll be coming up. We've got 36-9 left here in the first half. Dick, the Tar Heels have dominated.
Yeah, really not a good foul right there. 36 seconds. Take a look right here, leading at half 27 to 28 times. The only time they trailed by 16 to North Carolina, and now they're 13 down. Even that Michigan game, they were up 11 at halftime, and they were up 17 in the second half before losing to the combination of Bullock and Mr. Trailer. That's a really shocked bench. You don't see that enthusiasm. You see a stunned look.
And his first point of the game here. About a half minute to go in the first half.
I think almost everybody I was polling, trying to talk to people, they all were thinking, people not really aligned with Duke either, that this would be a Duke win.
Well, let's remember this. The Blue Devils were favored by a half dozen points. I mean, a lot of folks thought that this was going to be the Blue Devils' day, but
it's still a long way to go. We got a whole half to play.
There's Coda on the penetration, pull up. Good-looking play. Didn't get the basket, but Haywood has got no.
Another foul.
Be an offensive foul. He pushed off to get rebounding position, and now that's the third personal foul on Brendan Haywood.
Not only that, Brad, he's made 2 really bad plays here late, 36 seconds, and now with 8, the clock stops and they go to the foul line and get a chance to convert and put 2 on a board.
It's huge from a depth perspective. I know that Haywood's not one of their regulars and everything, but as the heat starts to wear away, if it ever does, the Carolina team, then having one of their two key reserves in foul trouble could be a problem. But we'll see how that unfolds.
Well, rattles it in. As Battier squares there, all year long, we said depth would be a factor for North Carolina in terms of the season, only six players. And then number two, we said today, the heat, and so far they've been able to take that heat and really wrap it up in the palm of their hand. But we got a whole half to go.
Hayne Weber believes that the best investment is an investment in education. And today they salute Wojo, Steve Wojciechowski, scholar athlete of the game, and they congratulate him. Hayne Weber recognizes that commitment to education with a $1,000 donation to Duke for ongoing research. Hayne Weber, you can't lose with an investment in the future. Wojo watching a lot of the action. His parents are here today. They're probably very nervous right now, hoping that the Blue Devils can pick it up, because Wojo struggled a little bit in the first game over Chapel Hill, as Adier rattles in another one now. Three for the game. Final 8 seconds. Duke trying to pressure the ball, trying not to give the Tar Heels a good look. And Shimon goes coast to coast and passes Dakota. Haywoods outs it in at the buzzer. The 7-footer. Underneath, there was no answer for him. Look who's walking off with a glass of water. Look at Coach Guthrie.
I know.
He looks like
relaxed.
A stockbroker. Look at it. He's going out.
He looks like the mayor. The mayor.
Dean, you should. Dean, happy birthday, by the way, but you should have turned it over to him a long time ago. Look at him. It's 42-30. John Saunders will get you up to date on everything that's happening. John, who knows? Maybe North Carolina has got Duke's number after all, huh, partner?
Brent, it is hard to believe the first time down at Carolina, you might take that one, but at
Carolina, the versatile and exciting 6'7 junior from Daytona Beach, Florida, averages around 16 points and 5 boards a game. He's also become a defensive stopper with over 27 blocks and 37 steals this season. Carter has the size and quickness to defend small, quick players and the strength to play inside. Vince Carter is the Naismith nominee of the week.
Birthday of a legend all around the country. Dean Smith today turns 67 years old, and February 28th in this state will forever be known as Dean Smith Day. Welcome back to Cameron Indoor Stadium, ladies and gentlemen. Let's have the camera across the way just kind of tighten up. We are up above, high up above in the loft, and Dick, this is a two-towel game for you, partner. I have never seen you in all the days work quite as hard as you have in this game. This truly is a big game. Did you bring along a change of shirts from Lorraine when you left Sarasota, my friend?
I'll tell you, I got some shirts back at the hotel, but you know what? They say genius is 1% inspiration and 99% perspiration, and we're perspiring up here. Look at this shirt. Hey, can I submit a bill? Will Bob Apter, our boss,
absolutely,
down here, let me submit a bill?
Oh, absolutely.
I could do that?
Go to the most expensive shop you can find. Speaking of stars here today, ladies and gentlemen, and working hard, watch Antoine Jamison get free, Dick.
I'll tell you, he's been brilliant here in the first half. They've had no matchup. McLeod's tried to check him. Battier's tried to check him. He gets into the lane. He was 5-for-6 in the first half. Take a look at this. They're putting away the Demons in their two losses. Duke has shot 37%. Wow. Unbelievable. Look, being out rebounded. And it's been a brilliant performance by North Carolina. As you look at the Gateway stats here, the big number, 31% for Duke in the first half. Very reminiscent of the first matchup when they shot 33% at halftime. And for Carolina, they lead the nation at 53.5, and they're 54 right now.
The picture to start the second half is Coach Mike Krzyzewski. You think it's not hot in here? You think he didn't need to change his luck over there on the sideline? Off goes the shirt and tie. Folks, the working attire is on. The polo shirt and no necktie. It's 42-30. It's a 12-point Tar Heel advantage. They'll work directly in front of Coach Guthridge here in the second half. Pressure defense as they pick it up now. Traveling. Duke's ball on the first possession. And Dick, just as you point out now, and you've said it all along, the first 5 minutes, we cannot overemphasize how important this is to the Blue Devils.
I really believe that these 5 minutes will dictate whether or not Duke is going to be in a position to come down the stretch with a chance to win. You play this game in segments right now.
Grant has it stripped, but McLeod, right man, right place. 11 for Rashawn.
Rashawn McLeod with that score. Good score.
A steal back. McLeod fires. This misses. Cota rebounding. Oh, that would have been huge in this building.
That would have brought the house down. There's a little offensive foul right there. Cota on Wojciechowski.
That is the only controversy in the buildup to this game. Cota said that in their first meeting, Wojciechowski fouled him a million times.
A million?
A million.
A million? What about a zillion? Hey, I'll tell you what, he's such the Rambo man. I see a look in the eyes of the Dukies. They really look like they're ready to play this half.
Well, there's Grant backing in for another one, Dick, just as you say it. That's five now for him.
That's big right there. Elton Grant giving him some presence. But what's bigger? That gets the student body alive to give him that sixth man, something that usually exists here.
Williams to the corner. Okalaja drops it down low, and there's Antoine Jamison. Yes, it stayed down for Antoine, and now 16 points.
Man, isn't he a great player? Every time they make a little run, superstars do that. That's what the great ones do. They respond in tough times.
Wojo has it blocked by Cota and out of bounds. And that time, look at the sideline. Look at Quinn Snyder.
Look at Quinn Snyder.
Look at Johnny Dawkins in behind him, the Duke graduates, one time. Fine players here. Dawkins, of course, one of the all-time greats as far as the Blue Devils are concerned. The pass is into Bland now. It's 44-34. The lead is 10.
Both staffs really have a passion for the uniform as they all played here. When you think of Phil Gore, Pat Sullivan.
Bland missed it, but an offensive rebound. Battier puts it back.
That's a big-time offensive rebound by the Diaper Dandy. I'll tell you, they're alive this half. They were not alive in that first half, Brent.
Cota drew the foul that time. That penetrating. Now watch Battier.
There's the right now. Look, the Grant with the shot, but here comes his buddy, the other freshman. Look at the extension and the reach and the long, long arms. Went to the same high school as Chris Webber, Detroit Country Day.
Great replay by our director, Drew Esikoff, our producer, Kim Belton. Thanks to all the fellas down in the truck for the outstanding work of the year. Jai has one hop in for him, and that's his first field goal of the game, and it's a big one.
He's really improved this year. He's provided some offense in the lane, had 16 in their recent win over Wake Forest, and they were down 14.
Now Brand wants the spot Langdon up, and here he comes. Missed on the shot, goes back hustling, but Cota comes up with the ball, puts a dribble move. Langdon not the quickest of defenders. Cota penetrates, and here's Antoine Jamison's look from the baseline. He's deadly, 18.
You know, he gets credit for the deuce, but it was a brilliant play in transition by Ed Cota, who's an outstanding passer.
17-35.
Every time it looks like they're going to make the run, the big players step up. Mr. Jamison, Mr. Cota.
Not giving Langdon the open look. But inside, Brand will go hard, and he drew the foul from Akhtar Jai. That's number four, and it is huge. Remember, Haywood, the freshman, is playing and saddled with three fouls. Guthrie's with a decision.
We take a look right now. Elton Brand is down inside, and he's trying to direct traffic. Look, he's up a traffic cop. He's going to play a little two-man game.
Here's Elton Brand. He looks powerful on the floor. He probably does not have the timing that he had before the injury back in December. Ed Cota, of course, very calm on the floor. He knew Antoine was over there, hitting beautifully with that pass for the assist. And now Brand comes back with the second free throw. And Elton Brand on the day with that miss has scored 6 points.
I think you talk about Ed Cota. He's going to become the all-time leader in assists eventually here at North Carolina. Has just that great vision, so unselfish, and that's what great teams have. Players that are
in deep. Jai on the right side with that jump hook, and he comes right back. Saddle with those fouls, he still contributes a field goal, which you like to see.
Big play by Akhtar Jai on the inside. Give him some post presence on the interior. We got to respect him down inside.
McLeod comes up over the top with a penetrating move for Sean. 13 points.
Yeah, Rashawn stepping up big here in the second half. But they got to make it happen if they're going to win with their defense. Their defense has been their catalyst all year, Duke. And their defense has been not a factor here against North Carolina.
On the screen comes Cota. Williams looks inside to the low block, and Jamison keeps it, penetrates, comes glass. Yes!
That's a great move by Shamon Williams. He's a kid that really is one of the underrated players in America. He's third in terms of a marquee value on his club behind Carter and Jamison. But I'll tell you this, you ask people around the league, he's flat out such a big game performer.
16-12, it's 52-39, the Tar Heels. First half, once they led by 16, Cloud short on that shot. But gets it right back and then drives to the glass and drew the foul.
Rashawn McCloud, a transfer from out of St. John's. Priscilla's got that club playing well. Felipe Lopez having a great year. Look at Shamon right now. Change of direction. Great change of direction. The ability to slide and glide down the lane and kiss it on the glass. He's got that look, that cocky look, that look of we're good, we're bad. Just like you, you are bad. You're the man, Mr. Busberger. I'm along for the ride.
Don't you think this is easy?
It's been fun all year. We got one more.
That's right. We go down to Clemson. I'll introduce you to the SO Club, my friend. You'll love every minute of it. Knocks down that free throw, 14 points. And a reminder, Johnston Scott. Johnston defends his title in that one. There's be some good action coming your way on ABC Sports. Of course, you never know about the boxing world. You know, show up to see. It's very unpredictable. 16. My friend Steve Wynn down there from the Mirage. No one knows any better than he does out in Las Vegas. Let me tell you. Okalaja cleans up with the rebound, and it is 52-40, a 12-point Tar Heel lead.
You know, Brent, there's no doubt if Carolina wins this basketball game, they're a lock for the number one seed out in Greensboro, and they've deserved it by winning two games here. If they lose this, I believe Duke will get the edge and get the number one seed.
He just fouled on the jump shot. He shoots a pair.
Goes to the line right now, and he's a great free throw shooter. And the reason I feel if Duke comes back and wins this, I think what will stand tall, even though they're 1-1, is the fact they beat Arizona, plus their margin of victory in the ACC over so many teams has been unbelievable. I think he ripped his tie off. I think he threw that shirt down, and he gave him a little bit of Polish right there. I wonder if they understood him. Wojciechowski understood him.
Williams coming to the free throw line.
Look at that look of concern. Intensity, seven times for the Final Four, two national titles back-to-back, 91-92.
I'll tell you one thing the scouts who are assembled and watching on television are going to learn. They're going to find out what kind of physical condition Antoine Jamison and Vince Carter are in, because they got to go the distance. And no question, they're not going to hold on in this building without their two premier stars out on the floor. It's a 13-point lead, make it now 14 on the Williams free throw. He scored 15 for the game. So far, here in Durham, it is all Tar Heels.
World of Sports Studio, I'm John Saunders. We're going to get you back up to Duke and North Carolina in a moment, but the women's ACC tournament underway. In one semifinal, North Carolina, a winner over Duke, 56-52. North Carolina will face either Clemson or Maryland tomorrow in the ACC final. At 4:30 Eastern and Pacific, this man, Steve Johnson, defends his WBC lightweight championship against George Scott in Atlantic City. It's all coming up on ABC Sports. Back to Brent and Dick.
All right, John, maybe an omen, huh? The Carolina women with a victory. And Wojciechowski brings it down here. The men lead 54-40. Lang didn't pull up and make it 42. He was inside the arc on that field goal that time. So it's 54-42.
Well, Trajan Langdon gets that look right there. He stepped inside the arc, as you said, Brent. The open deuce.
Carter comes right back at the other end. He has scored 8. Not letting Duke put a run together there.
I'll tell you one thing. Vince Carter was the guy they wanted badly here at Duke. They thought they had a shot, as did Florida, Florida State.
Turn it over. Langdon went baseline. On the pass, Jamison intercepted. Tar Heels come back down. You know, we keep waiting for the Tar Heels to show signs of fatigue, but let's remember they have played as a shorthanded unit all season long. So it isn't as though they haven't reached this point. There's a lot. There it is. Nobody any better than Cota. And backdoor from Vince Carter, 10 points. Oh, can he throw that lob pass?
And Mr. Carter can go up there and catch it with the best of them. He's the 3M man. He's magnificent, magical, and marvelous.
Carwell misses, one and out.
Look at Jamison running the court, too. First guy down the floor in transition. I mean, they're putting a whipping on him, Brent. They are really executing, just carving him apart. Great passing. Look at the field goal percentage here. Unbelievable.
There's Jai jumping back on the outside, and Vince Carter and Langdon with that quick first step. You can see the quickness as they bring it back, and Cota said, let's just slow it down. We got a lead. We got 10 seconds to go, and now we'll wind it down, and he'll take Wojciechowski. And here's Jamison stepping out for the deuce. If he has a weakness, it might be that. The foul going to be called on the Tar Heels.
Well, you know, everybody's got weaknesses, but I'll tell you what, I look at his strengths, and he's got so many strengths. As you see, Cota with the backdoor lob, and there is Carter, one of the great up-and-up guys, an elevator man, a high riser. There he is. Look at that catch. He's up in the sky. He's a skywalker, Mr. Carter.
Dick, the lead is 16. That matches their first half high. There's 13:58 to go. Duke does not have a lot of time to mess around. They need a run, and they need it badly to get down inside of 10 points.
I'll tell you, very tough to come from behind against Carolina the way they make free throws. They lead the ACC in free throw percentage.
Carrowell, extra step, no ball, got roll. That's interference. Oh, my goodness, how they miss that. Here comes Cota across the timeline. Williams penetrates. And Okalaja cross court open. Here comes Jai, attacks the paint. Can't get it loose. Langdon. Now McLeod plus five. Good defense by Cota. Down low to Burgess, the freshman. Turn around baseline. Good looking shot from 34.
Nice low post move by Chris Burgess, who was really highly rated last year. Top five in many of the polls. Part of the BB gang with Mr. Brand, Burgess, and Battier, the three Bs.
So tough to come back from this far down against Cota. There he is again, and John lays it in and scored and drew the foul. Eddie Cota working the back door perfectly.
I tell you, coming from the weak side, a backdoor screen. Duke does a poor job seeing ball, you man. You got to watch ball and you got to see man. They turn their back, little screen, and right over the top. Shamon Williams set that up for the screen, the little back screen. It's a must when defending the back screen that you communicate. Look at John. He's celebrating. He's an old Marco Polo. He's been in three schools, Wake Forest, Michigan, and now Carolina. That's a heck of a three of them.
Out. Antoine puts it back and misses, but that quick jumping step that he has, oh, is he going to pull down some rebounds in the NBA when he finally plays up there? That quick jump, quick hands, the things that that man can do down low.
And he's got great attitude. He's so mentally tough. He's got that tenacious competitiveness. Look how quick he is.
So quick. Williams fires and misses. Hand off now to Avery. Crossover to Wojo. Penetrating. Looks for the open man. It's McLeod. He'll fire the three. Got it. Good look.
Good execution. Triple penetration creates that opportunity. That's so big. Look at Wojo getting very emotional, trying to charge up his club. But so poised on the Tar Heels.
Langdon watching. And that's an interesting move by Krzyzewski. Jump by Jai. Battle for the rebound. Carolina dribbles it away, and Williams puts it in Okalaja's hands, and here's an open. Cota gave it up, hasn't shot well this game. He went baseline. Okalaja all alone on that side of the glass, Dick.
Just beating him on the glass. Nobody laying a body on him. Guys like Okalaja and Jai are great role players. They fill in so well for the stars. Cota, Shamon Williams, Carter, and Mr. Jameson.
The team that beats Carolina, North Carolina, and here's a three fired. Miss, and it was Antoine Jameson with another rebound. The team that beats him better bring some speed. I've got to believe that North Carolina State has some speed on that team after watching this unit. Look at that.
Look at
right
that.
On crashing through. They're as quick a team as you're going to see in a college game. That's 20 for Antoine Jameson.
You know, Jameson, if I were him, I'd take Mr. Cota out for dinner every night of the week. What a great look by Ed Cota to create that backdoor layup.
Speed kills, and the Tar Heels are dominating.
Payne Weber College Basketball on ABC Sports. Brought to you by MCI 5-Cent Sundays. Pay the least on the day you call the most. Gateway 2000 Direct Personal Computers. Audi and the all-new A6. Can one car change the way you look at all cars? And Aflac, insuring over 40 million people worldwide.
We're going to take a look right now how to get in transition after the missed shot. Now right here, watch North Carolina kick it out. Jameson, remember, made the pass. Now look at the vision. He's got his head up all the time. My freezer right here. See how his head is up? Now watch this. Right down the gut, and he's going to come the pass for a layup to Jameson. There it is, right down the gut. Great look. And I'm going to tell you this, Brent. No time in the history of the ACC, as you take another look from the low angle,
His head is up. Have there been three players from one team to make the All-ACC? Well, I'm voting for Ed Coder, Jamison, and Carter, and I'm putting Harpering and Trajan Langdon on that floor.
Coder making a good argument with six assists here. Dick Avery on the drive for Duke. They're playing catch-up. Foul is going to be called. It's 64-47, and you take a look at this situation.
I'll tell you right now, you talk about the Tar Heels that lead the nation as well as the ACC in field goal percentage, but in defense, they allow 38.9, as you saw that. And you said that earlier, and I couldn't agree with you more, how underrated their defense is. Just ask Duke, as they've really put the hurt on Duke both times defensively.
Haywood picks up his fourth personal, and William Avery rattles in his third free throw of the game. Dick, one of the things they possess for defense, and we watch it from up high, they've got wonderful quickness with their feet. Carolina is as quick as any team that I have looked at, and that picks up a lot of sins. If you release someone, you can quickly get there with a step, and I'm watching these Carolina kids. They can really move quickly.
And that's what Arizona has with Dickerson, Bibby, and Simon. They're so quick.
Jump hook from the freshman, not there. Battier, and ball going to go out of bounds. To remind you, we've got a lot of auto racing the next couple of weeks. For example, you know, a week from Sunday, Toyota presents the Grand Prix of Miami. So light it up down there in South Florida. That's always an exciting day down there in the Miami area. 11-13, 64-49. Carolina with a basketball lead, basically 2-point guard. Shimon handles the ball like that, missed the shot into Brand's hands, and Wojo brings it across the timeline. Duke needs to pick it up now. They desperately need a run right now. They're being out-rebounded. Again, that's Antoine Jamison as much as anybody down low. Avery penetrates. Here's the freshman. Low, good.
I'll tell you one thing. He's not afraid or bashful to shoot the rock. He steps right up. I love him. I think he's going to become a star here. He's a combination guard. And Wojo matched up out here is going to make something happen defensively.
Crowd climbing back in. Trying to encourage a run. Carter a little off balance, but Antoine Jamison drew the foul on the putback. And Antoine Jamison going to come up to that free throw line, and Duke simply must seal him off the glass, partner.
Well, you know, people have been saying that for the last 3 years about him, but he just keeps scoring. He keeps getting the lane inside. He's such an aggressive offensive rebounder. I hope he comes back to school. I know it's dreaming, but I'm hoping guys like Jamison and Carter, when they think about it and look at the success of Van Horn and Duncan.
Jamison misses the free throw. He has 10 rebounds to go along. Dick, if the folks around basketball, that includes us, can make a lot of money, the youngsters can too if they put it on the table. And then you just go out and you get more great freshmen and you come in.
I have no problem with kids leaving early in many cases if they can, with a stroke of a pen, take care of their families for life. All I'm simply saying is when you look at a Duncan and a Van Horn and a Brevin Knight and a Derek Anderson, it is shown that 4 years of college, you still can make your millions and you can become a great player. In fact, I'll go one step further right now. Duncan and Van Horn, to me, are better off now than Stackhouse and Wallace, who left early.
All right, it's 65-51 now. They punch it back down. Avery's going to fire the three. The inside, outside, short for the freshman. Williams with a rebound. Coder tries to break free. Here's the pass underneath, too far.
He's going to get
the line. Williams misses the shot. The freshman battles back for it. Haywood bumps bodies. Throw back. No, hold on. That's going to be traveling. He traveled. That's Duke ball.
Well, I'll tell you, Duke's got a shot to win, Brent. They have to make something happen with a little spurt. They have not had a spurt, and it better happen right now. Bill Guthridge's club has been in command all afternoon from wire to wire.
You know, along with Coda, who I certainly agree with, deserves to be on the team watching him here today. I got to tell you something. Guthridge would be my candidate for Coach of the Year if he comes with a double. 10:05 to go, and bounce it back down low. Brand up with a jump hook, score it, and now the freshman tries to ignite a fire.
That's a big play, Elton Brand with that big body on the inside. I know it's Bob Daisy out home in Peekskill.
Now, Jai leaves, and this is an important picture. As Jai walks off to Guthridge, they embrace. I want everybody to remember what happened in game one. As Matt Carr is standing over there in front of Coach Guthridge, he went to the floor. You folks in Chapel Hill remember it. He found out he slammed the ball on the floor. It was a 6-point play before it was over. This time, Jai walks over to the bench, sits down, did not say anything to the officials. A young man learning a lesson under good coaching. And it's 65-53, and there'll be no technical this time.
Well, learning how to mature, he put his arm in the embrace Coach Guthridge. In that scenario, if you remember, Duke went on a 15-0 spurt and cut that lead to four, and then it was blown out again with a 24-4 run by North Carolina. So they basically blitzed them twice, early in the game and then at the end of the game.
Now the man missing. Big free throw cannot miss when you're coming from behind. And Antoine Jameson's hands, he has still another board. 65-53, we're just inside of 10 minutes. Cameron Indoor Stadium, round two. The ACC regular season title at stake. They would both wind up with the same record if Carolina wins it, but Carolina would get the tiebreaker as a result of the sweep. They'd be seeded number one in the upcoming ACC tournament. Now from the corner, Okalaja dribbles it back outside. Now snaps it on into Carter, that turnaround for the baseline, no. Loose Wojciechowski going after it, and it was touched last by Carolina. The teams that are in, we feel. Duke, North Carolina, and Maryland. And then tomorrow, folks, be with us. Georgia Tech, Clemson. 4-5 down at Clemson. And the feeling on press row today is that the winner is going to make it to the NCAAs. We're on at noon tomorrow. Drop it into Bland now into Payton, the freshman. Again, coming. Here comes the Duke offense, Dick.
I tell you, Elton Brand really establishing great position inside because they have to respect the perimeter shooting of Langdon. Crowd really trying to get into it. I think seven is the magical number in the conference. Win seven and you're in the big dance.
Down to 9 minutes. 65-55. Okalaja, is this who you want making that shot? I don't think so, but Carter bails it out. Snaps a great pass, and Cota was the right man in the right spot. Bailed out that time, I think.
It's been Cota time, baby. All the right plays.
Brand is coming back. And the foul is called. Elton Brand taking the game over on the low block for the first time since what really is a minor miracle recovery from a broken bone in his foot.
I'll tell you one thing, Graham, what's really big is the fact that North Carolina is just crushing them on the glass. As you see the foul on Elton Brand, Carter with the foul. The bottom line is, it's tough to win a basketball game when you're being dominated on the glass the way they are being dominated.
Got a conversion. Free throw. He's struggling a little bit. The free throw line, and that's hurting him because now they'll put him there. He's only 4 of 8. He's 50%. North Carolina noting that. They won't be afraid to put the big fella on the line down the stretch.
Well, that's a lot of rhythm and timing, conditioning, stamina. As Al McGuire, our old buddy, would say, that's an Achilles heel right now. Michigan.
But back to the right man. Can he get them both back? He does. And it's 12. They save the day with a tap back. And it's 10 now. 8:33 in Carolina ball.
Tell you one thing, it's down to 10 right now. They gotta lock it up here. Little two-man game, Cota and Jameson.
Okalaja will not take the shot this time. Instead, he'll hit Williams. And there's gonna be a foul call. I thought he traveled with that.
I did too. I thought it was a little traveling music right there. Remember, going down the stretch, North Carolina, an outstanding free throw shooting team, and that's a big, big plus.
That's four personals on McLeod, and that is a big one. And Battier checks in and McLeod comes out. So they'll go with the two freshmen, Battier and Elton Brand, low against the Tars. You wonder now about fatigue with North Carolina. Jameson and Carter playing a ton of minutes in this hot setting Cameron Indoor Stadium. Carter pull up, snaps it off through the foul. He'll shoot a pair of free throws. Carrollwell didn't agree with the call. And the bench statistic, you know, you can see it over there. Brendan Haywood contributed a few minutes. He got himself into foul trouble. Maktar Jai has fouled out of the game. There are 8 minutes and 12 seconds left in this game with Vince Carter from Daytona Beach, Florida on the free throw line. A sign of fatigue is if you see your stars start to miss free throws, remember that in basketball. Watch NBA stars, their legs start to tire just a bit, and suddenly they'll miss free throws. And he hits this one, and now for number 15, it's 11 points.
I'll tell you a player that's been really silent today, Chris Carrollwell, who's been a tenacious competitor, and he's third in scoring for Duke, but he's been quiet.
Langdon rattles in the three, and it's huge.
It's down to eight, baby, it's down to eight. Well, again, the Duke said he stepped on a line. I think it was a good ball. We're way up here.
I only got the one eye, Brent. You got to help me out. You got two eyes.
With two eyes, I saw the 3-2. But
we're going to have a timeout now. It's still a big field goal. Carolina leads at 68-59. And our coverage continues after these messages and a word from our ABC station.
There's no question about this call. It was a good one.
No doubt about it. Take a look right here. Freeze it. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Great job of officiating right there. These guys, Hartzell, Gordon, and Scagliato, have done an outstanding job. They work so well as a team.
That's the key. Officials working as a team.
Look at this right here.
59.
I talked about it earlier, Brent. He has not been a factor. Had 19 in the first matchup. He's third leading scorer. He's got to step up and give him some productivity down the stretch.
Here's Jameis' two-hand pass to Williams underneath, and he missed the shot. Now Langdon crushes the floor for the Blue Devils.
Big, big possession right here. Might be the biggest so far here in the second half. They need a score here.
And load the turnaround.
Oh!
Elton Brand with 14 points is carrying the Blue Devils. They're within seven now, and fatigue appears to be setting in on the Tar Heels.
We talked about fatigue being a factor, and it could be coming down the stretch, but this place is rocking now, Brent.
Oda penetrates and Wojciechowski strips it from him.
Wojciechowski
eyes the floor as he comes to the left side. The three, Langdon, no. But the offensive rebound and a putback is good from Elton Brand.
Can't handle the big guy inside. There's a T.O.
To see Elton Brand on the floor. Win or lose here, what a factor he provides going into the tournament.
I think my friends like Dave Anderson, the New York Times, they should do a story with the x-ray. I mean, this is a miracle that this kid's out here playing. Nobody comes back from that fracture of that bone and plays as quickly as he did. It's a 5-point lead for Carolina. They've got the basketball now, and they put him over on Jameson. Brand is tracking a big fella.
Not only do they have him scoring on the inside, they're putting his big body to wear way on Jefferson.
Williams can't hit the drive. Loose ball. Duke goes for it. And Langdon called for the personal foul as he jumped out that time. And you could just see the body language on the part of Carolina. They're taking just a fraction of a second extra to get up from the one knee. There is no question that this is going to be the big story in this game. Dick Vitale said it at the top of the show that the one thing that favored Duke in here was depth and heat. Cameron Indoor Stadium without air conditioning, and it is muggy in here. 68-63 now. Okalaja with a free throw, and that's 3 points for the game.
They're 16 for 19 on the line, Brent, North Carolina. And you look at the score right now, the deficit is 6. Duke is only 14 for 23. Oh, how big that free throw line is. Look, it's not even hot. I mean, he's not even playing. Look at the perspiration. Look at it coming down on Maktar. Wow.
Okalaja at the free throw line. Big as they try to stay ahead, and he rattles in another one now, and it is 70-63, 6:29.
You know what this is reminiscent of? As Brand has scored 11 of the last 12 Duke points, this reminds me of the game you and I did here where Clemson came back and Duke was on the ropes.
Saving time. Now he picks it up and it starts. Clock doesn't start until he touches it. Wojo knows he got to conserve time, playing catch up. Down 7 now. Langdon ran through from the weak side, and now he cuts back, and Eponce low. They want Brand. He sends it on back outside, and here comes the freshman Avery. No. Brand hustles out. What a rebound by number 42. He's all over the place.
But they can't expect him exclusively to be the guy on the interior. They got to shoot some open shots. His presence inside is going to create some openings on a perimeter.
Avery coming again.
And he hits
it this time. 8 points. He's cold-blooded. It's 76.
66-552.
Two freshmen stepping up. And remember, North Carolina is a team with great poise, and they got such leadership out there with Cota. As a nice
Carter, backdoor, left hand, no basket, waved off. Foul is called before the shot. He had the backdoor, and foul before the wraparound.
I tell you, what a great moment to be in this house and to feel this electricity and to see this comeback and see North Carolina right now with the backdoor cup, and they get the foul on Carter. He's going to the line. You know what North Carolina, what impresses me, is they never show any panic. And that's such a reflection of Bill Guthridge. That's why he's my choice as National Coach of the Year, replacing someone like Dean Smith with that pressure.
Carter, a dozen points here as he comes back to the free throw line after making the first. 17 fouls on Carolina, 9 on Duke, with 5:41 to go.
I'll tell you, the foul line has been big, and they have really excelled on that line. As you look at the numbers of Carter today,
another one. They lead 72-66. Lead is at 6. Mojo quickly to the attack.
You got to sing their praises, North Carolina, the way they stuck to that line. And
Haywood is in, bumping on Brand underneath. They're going to try to force him off the block. The freshman without many fouls to take before he fouls out, but they're going to use the size. Langdon had it hit, so it was not traveling. Williams, good defense off Trajan. Trajan sometimes needs screens to get free. He's not the quickest off the dribble, and Williams stays right with him.
Nice,
and there's
screen.
That screen. Snap over to the corner now, and Avery will send it on back to Trajan with 5 on the shot. Penetrating move. Good for Langdon, 17.
Nice floating in the lane. And you're right, Brad. He's not going to feature with great dribble penetration. He needs to utilize that screen.
Here come the crazies.
Now, remember when they made their run in game 1, Carolina put them away when it got to 4.
It was Cota that did it. Remember those penetrating moves. But so far, they're keeping him well tracked on the outside. Carter fires a 3 off the front of the iron. Wojciechowski out hustles Williams and draws the foul. Here's a sign of fatigue, no question about it.
I couldn't agree more, Brad, but you know what else is a factor? Could be some fatigue. Antoine Jamison is not touching the ball in the last 10 minutes like he did early in the game. And that set in big against Maryland. Look at McLeod, he's cheering right now. Let's go, let's go. Two great schools, great coaches, great players. Look at the emotion here.
Kalaja checks back in. Very well. They wave him on the floor right now. Mojo takes a deep breath. They're back to within 4. 4:42. 16 was the biggest Tar Heel lead. They've had it twice. Once in the first half and once in the second half. Now Wojo comes up to the free throw line and he can pull the Devils to within 1-3.
Remember, all year long, they have not had to come back other than the one time against North Carolina.
That is Wojciechowski's first point of the game, and that was not his second. Knocked out, ball goes over. Devils thought they were going to break. They did not. 4:40 now, and Jamison steps out to take the ball out of bounds. 72-69.
You know, Elton Brand might need a minute just to go to the sideline and then come back in and regroup. He looks a little tired right now as well, and he's matched up with Jamison.
Trying to keep Cote on the sideline, but this time he was able to get over to the right side, but Wojo wouldn't give him the glass, and here's Williams. 3, no. Cote with the long rebound has possession. Wojciechowski right there, sticking right with him. They do not want to let 5 penetrate right now because that'll open everything up for him.
5 second moment,
a 5 second violation. Wojo forces a turnover.
See, right there, I think they did not utilize good basketball savvy in that they should have went right inside to Jamison against an exhausted Elton Brand.
Now the Devils can tie it with a 3 or inch to within 1.
Wow, if they tie it, this place, the roof will come off.
He's been handling the ball. Wojo's been an off guard for much of this half. Penetrating move. They snap Wojo. 3. No. And Cota with the rebound. And Carolina survives that assault.
I tell you, they had the great look with dribble penetration by Avery to Wojciechowski, who's a pretty good long-range shooter.
They have got to try to get Antoine Jamison back in the attack. Cota goes penetrating. Cota comes up off the glass, and there he is. In and out. Good. Carter was on the other side. They give Jamison credit for the tap back. That's 23 for Antoine Jamison. Great look by 33.
That's been a bit of difference in his game on the glass.
McLeod in the paint. 19.
Rashawn McLeod showing that good ability and that versatility that he can step on the interior.
74-71. Heels lead, Heels basketball.
I would go to Jameson right now. I think Grant is tired and exhausted.
Here comes the steal. No, Avery can't get it. Williams regains control, and Cota will come penetrating. Grant pass inside, and the foul on Carter did not score the field goal. Went to the windmill that time, and as he brought the ball down, that allowed the defender to make sure that he could not make the field goal, but he will be shooting free throws.
But what a great look by Eddie Cota with the left hand. A little shake and bake, and there's the kick with the left hand, and there's the contact to make him go to the line.
Vince Carter with 13 points on this game. The sweat just dripping from everybody, especially the Tar Heels. We've gone the distance here in the heat of Cameron.
One of their goals today, Duke defensively, was to shut down the dunkathon and the unbelievable momentum that could be created off his dunks. He's really had one dunk here today.
14 points, Langdon and Battier check in. Avery and Brand will get a break, an ovation for Brand. They'll get rested, 2:55. Fresh Warriors on the floor. Guthrie's basically out of ammunition. He's got to go with the five he's got on the floor now.
Not a bad five to go with, just a matter of, as we said, those legs get a little heavy. This place is so hot.
Rebound off the miss. A lot of thought about it. Elijah right there, and he gives it up to now to Wojo. They've got plenty of time.
Yeah, they shot too quickly in their comeback in their first matchup. They got to be patient here.
McLeod to the paint, flashes again, and they can't stop him in there. That's 21 for Rashawn, the senior.
Nobody rotated over to take away his driving angle. It's down to the deuce, and the camera plays. He's our explosive.
Against one of the greatest spectacles in sports, Carolina tries to hang on. Bad pass, turn it over. Now the Devils can tie or go ahead with the tray.
And Rashawn McLeod makes the defensive play. Remember, he's not as tired. He's sat some good minutes, so he's ready.
Here's a flash to Carowell. He's into the paint, and he! Oh! That's oh! His
where
first field goal of the game, and it ties the score at 75 inside of 2 minutes, and the exhausted Warriors from Chapel Hill try to find a solution.
Chris Carowell makes the big play. He's been a silent man today.
They've turned it over. This is a tired basketball team.
They are tired, baby. They're like a fighter on the ropes. Hanging on. Oh, don't leave now. This is what we wanted.
Timeout in Cameron. We are back. Game is tied at 75. Antoine Jamison calling on every ounce of courage, ability, and stamina that he has left. Somehow taps it in, Dick.
And Jamison gets the big tip. He's been silent the last five, but here comes Carowell, who's been silent the entire game. That's the first deuce for Carowell, who had 19 in their first matchup. As you look at the heat in this place, the perspiration, these players, these Goliath athletes, I tell you, these are two of the great programs in college basketball, going head-to-head with a minute and 36 ACC outright championship at stake for Duke.
Langdon for the lead. No bad miss, but rebound Duke. And Carowell hands it off to Wojo at 1:26. They'll slow it down now.
I'll tell you, managing the clock right now is so important. Basketball IQ. They got Brand back on the floor. See, I would go to Brand right now. He was resting. I would bring it inside to the big fella against Okalaja.
To the ball side right now with Okalaja, but they haven't looked down. They bring it down toward 10. Now McLeod off the dribble, goes to the glass on the left side for the lead. Duke leads it. First time, 77-75. Inside of a minute.
Little Wojciechowski pounding the deck. That means get down and play defense, baby. Rashawn McLeod stepping up big.
Got it down low, and they tie him up. And goes over to Duke. The possession arrow favors the Devils.
Well, you know, in that possession right there, they made it happen with their defense. And their defense created that opportunity. They're alive here. Oh, are they alive here, the Bears.
Now such a big possession. Can the Devils get on a four-point lead or even greater at 42 seconds? It is so critical for them right now. This would be the comeback of the season as far as the Blue Devils are concerned, especially in the ACC. Meanwhile, North Carolina trying to hang on here, and Mike Krzyzewski's strategy is to bring the clock down, take seconds off, reduce the length of the game as much as he can right now. Carrawell in the corner. They are going inside of 10. Carrawell fires corner short. Not the shot they wanted in that situation.
No, really a bad shot. Shot selection not good.
Now Cota looking to penetrate. Cota has it knocked away, but it is North Carolina ball, this time on the possession arrow.
Timeout.
Tied up. Okalaja, so they will talk about it. They're down two. Guthrie's will bring everybody over for this 20-second timeout. And they're going to use their full timeout with 9.5 seconds.
MCI 5 Cent Sundays lets you...
9.5 seconds remain. North Carolina's ball out of bounds. And a reminder that tomorrow, more drama coming your way. Could there be an NCAA berth at stake? Georgia Tech, Clemson, find out. Kansas, as they prepare for a run at the national championship. UMass against Temple. UMass tough again. There you see our timeout situation. And, of course, Duke just using their last... full. The possession arrow, remember, if they can tie them up, favors the Blue Devils. Do not look past that right now.
I'll tell you, Brent, right now, if this baby goes to OT, certainly the edge goes to Duke because of depth and because of the fact of so much fatigue. The bottom line is they're going to try to create an opportunity with some dribble penetration, most likely by Cota, and put, as you and I were talking off the air, Jameson for the offensive rebound, and maybe Shamon Williams spotting up for a three. They'll take whether it be the easy deuce or if a good look at the three is there, they will take it if available.
Now, reminder that John Saunders will be coming up next. It's our U.S. Army Reserve post-game report. I'm sure that John and the fellows in the studio are sitting on the edge of their seats right now, and our crew down here has done a wonderful job of bringing you coverage of this game. 9.5 seconds to go.
It's and amazing, partner. Number one seed in Greensboro at stake, ACC regular championship. Duke could be the first team in the conference to win 15 regular season games. No one's ever achieved that since they expanded in 92.
Cota will take the ball out of bounds. They didn't show that after they walked out of the huddle earlier. Cota will inbounds the ball, and he does it to set the defense. Seems on the floor. Then Guthridge will call another timeout, and now they will set what they want to do because it's only a 20-second timeout.
You know, I really think in that situation, he wanted Cota to make the quick throw, come back on the floor, and get the ball back.
Heavyweights of college basketball slug it out here in the WBC Lightweight Championship coming up next. Again, 9.5. seconds to go, and they take Cota off the ball after they saw the defense. They'll take Vince Carter out of bounds. Here comes the inbound.
Penetration.
Cota. 8 seconds.
Penetration.
7 seconds. Here comes Cota.
They fouled him.
Langdon stepped in, and Cota draws the foul. And he'll come to the. It was a good call. That look up here is Langdon got there too late, and Cota comes to the line.
Take a look now. Let's see if he jumps out. I thought initially it was a charge. Oh, no, he blocked. He jumps out. No doubt about it. He did not have good defensive position. Excellent call by the officials from up here. Look at that angle.
So now, Ed Cota.
He teaches that. Hedging, step out, try to take the charge. Right now, Cota goes to the line. They've been brilliant all year on this free throw line. He's up big, baby.
He's missed none at the line today. He's perfect. 4 of 4. He's hit one field goal.
Got to watch that missed shot because Jameson is such a rebounder. They're going to lay a body on Jameson. That's his mom and dad. His dad is paralyzed from that accident. He came down here for the game. The mom to the left. It's his stepdad. Accident happened in Panama. They got to really block out Jameson, Brent.
Here comes Cota. Missed it. Now with 3.8, you would expect him to miss
20-second timeout.
20-second timeout over here. Krzyzewski's going to tell him right now, you have got to keep Jameson off that glass as they go to miss this shot.
They will miss this free throw, and they will try to move Carter or Jameson hard toward the glass off the miss.
Well, they're going to have to block out in a game earlier this year in the ACC. North Carolina State on a missed shot by C.C. Harrison. He really violated the rule and stepped across the line, but got it back and scored. And there's his dad and his mom. His mom can't look, drops her head, but she has a lot to be proud of. And Coda is a winner, as all these Carolina kids are, and the Dukies. Take a look at the reset right there.
This is the moment. There's 3.8 seconds left in this game.
They got Brand, the big body. They're going to try to step out. Look at Jameson. They're trying to get a lane.
Jameson muscles in. Jameson for the ball. The tap back. Haywood's
got it.
Nothing.
Foul.
Brand fouled Haywood.
They got the foul. They didn't really block out.
1.2, and they're going to get a second chance here at the free throw line to knot it up.
Oh, I don't think there's any doubt. He missed that on purpose right there, Brand. I don't think there's any doubt whatsoever. You said that a little bit earlier. No question. And right now they're playing volleyball up on the clock. Got Haywood on the free throw line, the young freshman.
7-foot freshman misses also. And now they'll go back to square one. And now Duke will call a timeout. And they will remind everybody to be careful at 1.2 seconds.
Isn't it amazing? One of their great strengths, the free throw line, comes back to be an Achilles heel here late in the game. What a brilliant comeback to put themselves in a position to win the ACC title by 2 games, which to me, no matter what happens in phase three if they meet, I gotta believe they've earned the right to be the number one seed with a win over Arizona as well, and winning the conference by 2 games if they win this game, Mr. Musburger.
It is possible, ladies and gentlemen, that this is round two of a four-rounder.
Yes, sir.
Without these two teams getting to San Antonio, they're that kind of talented basketball teams. And now the second one, he'll miss it. Off to the side, Carter couldn't do it. Loose, scrambling on the ball, puts it over! Duke wins it! 77-75, a great comeback for the Blue Devils. The first team in the history of the ACC to win 50 regular season games. And it came right down to the end. Coach Guthridge and the Tar Heels. Twice they had opportunities at the free throw line. First it was Ed Cota missing the first. Then it was Brendan Haywood. And the game was over as they scrambled for the rebound. Our Audi play of the day.
Look at Wojciechowski's senior day. Emotion galore. Look at him right there. He'll be a future coach here at Duke. No doubt about it. He's looking for his coach. He says, I love you, coach. I love you.
He is the first athlete I've ever had break away from practice with his parents watching in delight over what has happened here today. But he is the first athlete Dick and I have had who broke away from a pregame drill and came over and said, I want to thank you two guys for covering me for 4 years. And he said, Mr. Vitale, you stuck with me when a lot of people were down on me as a freshman. And today, Wojo and the Devils come from 16 down to record one of the biggest victories ever in Cameron. What is it about this great arena? 58 years. They've won almost 600 games. But the one they wanted most of all against their arch rival. But do not rule North Carolina out next week at the ACC tournament. This is a great basketball team. Somewhat shorthanded, but the Tar Heels have got every other answer.
I really believe that fatigue became a factor down the stretch, and I haven't changed my opinion one iota, Brent. My Final Four are Duke, North Carolina, also Kansas and Arizona, all the chalk. They are clearly better than everyone else, but the beauty of college basketball is that the best team doesn't always win in a one-game scenario, as we saw last year with Arizona winning the national title.
We thank a lot of people, especially the folks over at the Siena Hotel, where we have been quartered over in Chapel Hill. It's a lovely oasis. Kim Belton, our producer, Drew Ezikoff, our director, our technical director, Mike Voigt, audio, Wendell Stevens, stage manager up here. She did a great job trying to keep us dry. Kathy Campbell, and stats all season long, Big John Madry. He has seen too many of these Duke North Carolina games to remember, but he'll be thinking about this one for a long time. What a win for the Blue Devils. So long, everybody.
Weber College Basketball on ABC and Raycom Sports. Brought to you by Payne Weber. When you invest with Payne Weber, you invest with more intelligence. The United States Army Reserve. Be all you can be. DirecTV. What are you looking at? And Alabama's Robert Trent Jones Golf Trail. Golf worth the drive.